Now I'm going to showing the difference between the block level tag, inline elements, block level elements, programmatical differences. Coding wise, how we'll get the difference in output, or what is the differences are comes. Now we are taking a small HTML program here. A small HTML program. So first I'm creating here one H1 tag. Even you can take the division tag or paragraph tag, any tag is okay. That's not a problem. Okay, you can take the division tag. Write a small message, hello world. Division tag, close. This is division tag. It's a block level element. Moreover, it's a container also. Similarly, I'm taking one span tag also here. Similarly, I'm taking one span tag also here. So span inside also, we are writing a small message, welcome. Span inside also, we have the small message, welcome. So division is a block level tag, block level element, and span is a inline element. Now we'll run this program. So generally, as output wise, we are unable to find any difference. See that one. How the hello world is displayed, welcome also displaying in the same manner. There is no special procedure in that, but differences available. We have a lot of differences. So if you want to observe the differences, then we have to make a small thing. Go to the inspect option. Go to the inspect option. So right click, go to the last option, inspect. And right side, we'll get our source code. Our web page or our website, source code available in the right side, observe that one. Now take the mouse pointer, place on the division tag. Take the mouse pointer, place on the division tag. Now see the blue color box area. How much space if division tag is occupied, sir? The whole line. Left side or right side, small gap available, that is default margins. But basically, there's a whole line occupied. A blue color, light blue color box observe. Let's take the same mouse pointer, place on the span tag. Now observe the here. The sizes also displaying the browser, you can observe that one. The span tag size is 60 by 17. Our points, if you remove it, 60 by 17. The size of the division tag is 537 by 18. That is not fixed amount. When you reduce or increase this size, that automatically size increasing, see that one. Now observe the division tag size, full line. Now again adjust this one. But observe the span tag. How much is size available for your web page or body? It's not depending on that one. They have their own size. That size is welcome. A 7 letters related space only it is occupied. And this is full line is occupied. This is the first difference. Size. And welcome to the second one. Welcome to the second one. Take the one more division tag here. Add one more division tag and write any other message. Suppose hello Hyderabad and division tag is close. This one. And take one more span. Take one more span. Write one more message. How are you? And close the span tag. Now run the program once again. I can observe the alignment of the data. We can observe the alignment of the data. Hello world in the separate line. Hello Hyderabad in separate line. Hello world in the separate line. Hello Hyderabad in separate line. But while it comes to the welcome and how are you, sir? The both are displaying on the side by side. Both are displaying on the side by side. We can crash check in. Go to the inspect option once again. So this is the first span tag. Small blue color box, light. And this is the second span. Both are displaying the side by side. But welcome to the division tag. This is separate line and this is separate line. So every block level element, they comes in the separate line. Every inline elements, generally they comes in the side by side. Second difference alignment. Practically we are implemented. First difference is size. Observe the blue color box size, you will get the difference. Second difference, alignment, right? Now go to the third one, event handling. The third one is event handling. Write a small event here. OnClick equals to. A small event handling we are implementing. OnClick equals to. Alert followed by hello world. On which element we are clicking, that message I'm going to displaying directly. Alert followed by hello world. Close this. We implemented an event on division tag. Similarly, write the same event on span. OnClick equals to. Alert followed by welcome. And close this. Now run the program, we'll get the difference. So go to the first division tag, click on the hello world message, click on hello world message, event triggered, and you will get the message also hello world. Where we click it, sir? Exactly on the top of the data. A data opposite, we have lot of empty space available. So click here, still event is triggering. And go to the end of the line, click again here, still event is triggering. Means in that whole line, the total line, if you click anywhere, the event is going to respond. The block level tags nature generally. Now comes to the welcome. Click on welcome, event triggered. This is welcome. And welcome after, you take the small space, click here. Up to that one, span tag is available. Now comes to the hello, how are you? This one, click here. No event is triggering, see this one. Even if you remove the how are you. Refresh the page. Welcome opposite, we have the space, na? Click here. See that, when I'm clicking, no response from the system. But click on the E, it's responded. So, for inline element, how much area is impacted for event handling, sir? How much content available, that much of area only. So content outside, if you click in this empty area, events are not going to respond. But while it comes to the block level element, content opposite, we have some empty area. In that empty area also event triggering. So this is the another difference between the block and inline tags. Thank you all.